Darkness is no darkness with you, O Lord, but the night is as clear as the day.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 73.
Truly God is good to Israel, to those who are pure in heart.
But as for me, my feet have nearly slipped. I had almost tripped and fallen,
because I envy the proud, and saw the prosperity of the wicked.
For they suffer no pain, and their bodies are sleek and sound.
In the misfortunes of others they have no share. They are not afflicted as others are.
Therefore they wear their pride like a necklace, and wrap their violence about them.
Their iniquity comes from gross minds, and their hearts overflow with wicked thoughts.
They scoff and speak maliciously, out of their haughtiness they plan oppression.
They set their mouths against the heavens, and their evil speech runs through the world.
And so the people turn to them, and find in them a fault.
They say, how should God know? Is there any knowledge in the Most High?
So then these are the wicked, always at ease they increase their wealth.
In vain have I kept my heart clean, and washed my hands in innocence.
I have been afflicted all day long, and punished every morning.
Had I gone speaking this way, I should have betrayed the generation of your children.
When I try to understand these things, it was too hard for me,
until I entered the sanctuary of God and discerned the end of the wicked.
Surely you set them in slippery places. You cast them down in ruin.
Oh, how suddenly do they come to destruction. Come to an end and perish from terror.
Like
A reading from the book of Ezra, the 7th chapter, beginning in the 27th verse. Blessed be the Lord, the God of our ancestors, who put such a thing as this into the heart of the king, to glorify the house of the Lord in Jerusalem, and who extended to me steadfast love before the king and his counselors, and before all the king's mighty officers. I took courage, for the hand of the Lord my God was upon me, and I gathered leaders from Israel to go up with me. Then I proclaimed a fast there at the river Ahava, that we might deny ourselves before God, to seek from him a safe journey for ourselves, our children, and all our possessions. For I was ashamed to ask the king for a band of soldiers and cavalry to protect us against the enemy on our way, since we had told the king that the hand of our God is gracious to all who seek him, but his power and his wrath are against all who forsake him. So we fasted and petitioned our God for this, and he listened to our entreaty. Then I set apart 12 of the leading priests, Sherebiah, Hashabiah, and 10 of their kin with them, and I weighed out to them the silver and gold and the vessels, the offering for the house of God, that the king, his counselors, his lords, and all Israel there present had offered. I weighed out in their hand 650 talents of silver and 100 silver vessels, and 100 talents of gold, 20 gold bowls worth 1,000 darics, and 2 vessels of fine polished bronze, as precious as gold. And I said to them, "You are holy to the Lord, and the vessels are holy. And the silver and the gold are a freewill offering to the Lord, the God of your ancestors. Guard them and keep them until you weigh them before the chief priests and the Levites and the head of families in Israel at Jerusalem, within the chambers of the house of the Lord." So the priests and the Levites took over the silver, the gold, and the vessels as they were weighed out, to bring them to Jerusalem, to the house of our God. Then we left the river Ahava on the 12th day of the first month, to go to Jerusalem. The hand of our God was upon us, and he delivered us from the hand of the enemy and from ambushes along the way. We came to Jerusalem and remained there for 3 days. On the 4th day, within the house of our God, the silver, the gold, and the vessels were weighed in the hands of the priest Merimoth, son of Uriah, and with him was Eleazar, son of Phinehas. And with them were the Levites, Jozabad, son of Jeshua, and Noadiah, son of Binu. The total was counted and weighed, and the weight of everything was recorded. At that time, those who had come from captivity, the returned exiles, offered burnt offerings to the God of Israel, 12 bulls for all Israel, 96 rams, 77 lambs, and as a sin offering, 12 male goats. All this was a burnt offering to the Lord. They also delivered the king's commission to the king's satraps and to the governors of the province beyond the river, and they supported the people and the house of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Apocalypse of John, the 17th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Then one of the seven angels who had the seven bowls came and said to me, "Come, I will show you the judgment of the great whore, who is seated on many waters, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and with the wine of whose fornication the inhabitants of the earth have become drunk." So he carried me away into the spirit in the wilderness, and I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast that was full of blasphemous names, and it had seven heads and 10 horns. The woman was clothed in purple and scarlet, and adorned with gold and jewels and pearls, holding in her hand a cup full of abominations and the impurities of her fornication. And on her forehead was written a name, a mystery, Babylon the Great, mother of whores and of earth's abominations. And I saw that the woman was drunk with the blood of the saints and the blood of the witnesses to Jesus. When I saw her, I was greatly amazed. But the angel said to me, "Why are you so amazed? I will tell you the mystery of the woman and of the beast with 7 heads and 10 horns that carries her. The beast that you saw was and is not, and is about to ascend from the bottomless pit and go to destruction. And the inhabitants of the earth, whose names have not been written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, will be amazed when they see the beast, because it was and is not and is to come. This calls for a mind that has wisdom. The 7 heads are 7 mountains on which the woman is seated. Also there are 7 kings, of whom 5 have fallen, 1 is living, and the other has not yet come. And when he comes, he must remain only a little while. As for the beast that was and is not, it is an 8th, but also to the 7, and it goes to destruction. And the 10 horns that you saw are 10 kings who have not yet received a kingdom, but they are to receive authority as kings for 1 hour, together with the beast. These are united in yielding their power and authority to the beast. They will make war on the Lamb, and the Lamb will conquer them, for he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and those with him are called the chosen and faithful." And he said to me, "The waters that you saw, where the whore is seated, are peoples and multitudes and nations and languages. And the 10 horns that you saw, they and the beast will hate the whore. They will make her desolate and naked, and they will devour her flesh and burn her up with fire. For God has put it into their hearts to carry out his purpose by agreeing to give their kingdom to the beast until the words of God will be fulfilled. The woman you saw is the great city that rules over the kings of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now,
of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. Almighty and merciful God, it is only by your gift that your faithful people offer you true and laudable service. Grant that we may run without stumbling to obtain your heavenly promises. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with all who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying. Soothe the suffering. Pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake.
Amen.
As today this nation concludes its processes of election throughout the nation, so we pray for the country, for all who presently serve and those who will serve in public office, in the chambers of Parliament, and in the office of President. Lord God Almighty, you have made all the peoples of the earth for your glory, to serve you in freedom and in peace. Give to the people of our country a zeal for justice and the strength of forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to God for the freedoms, the plenty, and the peace that we enjoy in this nation, placing the future of this nation into his hands, and working ourselves for the good of his kingdom here. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. above all for your immeasurable love, in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honour and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.